All done. Right, I enjoyed myself that much last week over at Sgairneach Mhor Beinn and came. Took another day off work and I'm back up. What else is the same area? There's A9 again. And there's two main roads I've still to bag in this area. So I was explaining last week, Sgairneach Mhor's one and Beinn Udlamain's other one. That's Sgairneach Mhor up there. So we get these two done today. Then that's the Munros in this immediate area all bagged. And that Drumochter pass, is it? The railway sign. Sorry mate.
Sorry.
Well, then. That's what happens when you walk with a camera. Right, so if I get these two bagged and it's on to pastures now, I think I've only got about 16 or 18 cairngorms to bag, and that's where you bagged them all. And that's not my plan. Plan is to leave the cairngorms and drag them out, but for me, this is where I usually get the best of weather, so this is where I head up. It's always my intention to go over to the west and a bit north, but I always end up here. I'm not complaining, but it just seems to be the script. So there's the two main roads there, Sgairneach Mhor, the Crescent Bridge on the left, and Beinn Udlamain on the right. It's a circular route, there's no backtracking to a fork in the path this time. Thank God. Just to head down here under the bridge. I've actually been over there. It's coming back for summer, can't remember where in the winter walking the path had a wee look down to the bridge. So far as I got. Got a couple of hours to spare. So I know the route. Quite a straightforward one. Loads a bit of height coming down Sgairneach Mhor, but it's not too bad. But looking forward to seeing views of Loch Eric and Beinn Udlamain, places like that. Right. There's a bridge you cross over, and after that it just leaves a faint path up, and there's a path back. So your route's pretty straightforward. So the bridge is just down there, and there's a path there. Just turn off here and follow it up. Just in that general direction. Up on the Crescent Bridge, so much just up there. That's the first Munro, Sgairneach Mhor. Right, no far to go to the top now. It's an hour and a half I've been walking. And the summit is just up there. It's the summit ridge. In another 20 minutes that'll be me. There's a summit ridge. That's what I've been waiting for. Looks excellent. Really good views for here. A perfect day I've got. No wind or nothing. Shelling. It's Sgairneach Mhor Beinn, it's just up there. There's a second Mhor Beinn Udlamain. And if you're interested, Gael Carn's over there and the Varkinich's over there. That's the four. And Carnacaim, the Voynich Beg's over there. That's just six Munros for the Drumochter area. Good Munros, I must admit. Good long walks, good exercise. Yeah, it's got up here. Just up there, it's the first summit. It's Sgairneach Mhor. There we go, Sgairneach Mhor. The trig point, and there's the cairn. That was a good walk. I enjoyed that. It's a good Munro. Right, Beinn Udlamain next. That's the summit shelter cairn over there. Where is it? There it is. That's no, where is it? Ah, there it is. For that, I'm heading down there. Down into Corrie, then head straight up. Then from there, it's over to there and down. Simple route, straightforward, all in front of you, which is good. There's Loch Erricht and then Voyle and Ben Alder over there. There's the rest of the Alder Munros. They look brilliant. A viewer. Right. No far to go for up here. Just up there. There, Udlamain. There you go, Ben Udlamain. Ah, excellent. Nice wee seat. What's left there? Ah, brilliant. Ah, good. Really enjoy that. It's a nice walk from over there. Great views of Loch Erricht as well. That's Ben Udlamain. Right. It's lovely views of Beinn Udlamain. You know, I've been climbing these two main roads. I've been paying more attention to over there. I know I shouldn't, but it looks amazing. Right, back to the motor. At this point I'm going to turn right and head back down to the path, but that's a Sgairneach on the right and Gaelcar on the left. If you're doing the whole shebang, just head up there and back a bit and head over to Gaelcar and head back down to the Balspawn cottage. I've already done that too, so I'm going to take a right and head down back to Carn, about an hour and a half I think. That's me back in the path. So take me back to the motor. It's about an hour I think. When you're heading down for there, there's a path and there isn't a path, you know what I mean? There is at the start, and I think the middle third, you're through hell. Or maybe I just lost it, then you regain it again. We just watch as a ravine's here. Don't head into that. Obviously. State of obvious, Peter. And you'll just regain the path and you'll head down. I'll take you down to there. And for here, job's done more or less. Just take your time up back the motor. We'll state of obvious again.